Hello everyone, this is Professor Shaista Khanam of Electronics and Telecommunication Department. I am going to introduce the subject Microelectronics. Microelectronics, it is a part of VLSI. VLSI is classified into analog VLSI, digital VLSI and mixed VLSI. Analog VLSI is a study of analog amplifiers like power amplifiers, oscillator. Digital VLSI is like memory, then flip-flops, which you'll be studying in 6th semester. Mixed VLSI, it is a combination of analog and digital, for example, mobile phones, which you'll study in your 7th semester. So, right now, in the semester, we'll study analog amplifier, which is called as microelectronics. In this subject, we'll be introducing you to MOSFET, importance of scaling, various amplifiers using MOSFET and fabrication of IC. Now what is IC? IC, it is an integrated circuit on a small wafer which can function as an amplifier, oscillator, timer, microprocessor, etc. So depending upon the number of transistors per wafers or chip, ICs are classified into small scale integration, medium scale integration, large scale integration, very large scale integration and ultra large scale integration. It depends on how many transistors you are using per chip. Our main emphasis is on VLSI. As we know that sophisticated and compact chips are available in a market, which is possible due to the technological advancement in a domain of VLSI. Now, IC fabrication. ICs are fabricated by using these steps. Now, as the chip size is reducing, hence making the IC fabrication more tedious task. Now, why we need integration? This picture can easily explain. This is the size of a first computer developed by Charles Babbage in 1823, and this is nothing but a laptop which we use nowadays. So, you can see this is possible due to the integration. With integration, first there is improvement in a size because in a small wafers more transistors are used, so it is becoming compact. Then cost is reducing. Then it can affect a very important parameter, power also, and it can also improve the speed. Now the key component of VLSI is MOSFET. MOSFET is metal oxide semiconductor Hall effect transistor. In your previous semester, you must have studied BJT, JFET and MOSFET. But MOSFET is used in VLSI because it needs less chip area, less steps in fabrication of MOS, and with the dynamic circuit technique, the size of the circuit can be reduced, power improvement we can get. Now, scaling. As we know that the chip size is reducing, so chip size is reducing, but density of the chip is increasing. Because now, for example, our smartphones which we are using right now is more compact, but the functions we can do in our mobile phones, if we compare with the 10 years back, then the more functions can be done in a more compact devices, which is possible due to scaling. So, which is possible due to the scaling of transistors. Now, 7 nanometer technology is currently used in industry. What is technology? Technology is nothing but a size of a MOSFET. So, you can imagine 7 nanometer transistor size is right now used in industry for manufacturing chips. Then, single stage amplifier, differential amplifier, power amplifiers are analog amplifiers, which you have studied in your previous semesters also. But here you will see how these amplifiers can be implemented using MOSFET. So it will combine the benefit of MOSFET and will improve the properties of these amplifiers. After this studying this subject, you will be able to understand fabrication process, understand and able to analyze MOSFET, importance of scaling and various amplifiers using MOSFET. VLSI finds its application in almost every field. Consumer electronics, defense, automotive electronics, wireless, wireline, medical electronics, etc. application of like smart system, they are using portable devices, variable devices, then chips, ultra chips, ultra thin chips are possible. Then future applications like IoT, healthcare and smart city. So design is not just what it looks like and feels like. Design is how it works. This is a quote by Steve Jobs, a founder of Apple, which is a giant consumer, giant manufacturer of the smart accessories. So VLSI is driving a market and making design work. So VLSI professionals are in high demand, and as it is an ever growing field, India is considered to be one of the important center for chip manufacturing, and we have more than 160 chip design center in India. These are some of the companies in which the VLSI domain job opportunities lie. These are some of our alumni which are working in prestigious VLSI domain companies like Cadence, KLA, Tencor, NVIDIA, AMD. So, department is having a good alumni connect. So, along with the teachers, alumni can also help to guide you. So, we expect some of you will be part of these companies in near future. So, all the best. Thank you.